formerly Ellen Cockrell from Metropolitan AME Church.
All right.
I now reside in Houston, Texas. I'm Helen Reed. My husband just retired from pastorage at Green's Chapel, African Methodist Episcopal Church.
Me, you pastor.
sermons, out of everything. Nothing stuck with me but that song. Yes, Jesus loves me. And that's what brought me to Christ, was that song. So don't think what you do here in Metropolitan is in any means a waste. Because everybody's going to stretch the rubber band. But somewhere a seed has been planted, a song has been sung, and it will lead you back to Christ.
Right. We're going to move into now. I hope y'all are proud of this little girl as I am. My own daughter.
Yeah. Okay.
We're going to listen to selection of that.
Johnson. All right. Joanne Stoker and Irvin Butler. And it says here he loves his big sister. Our next 2-year-old, Brother John Paul J.P. Pratt.
Love the dance. Reverend Cherry Johnson.
Very good society. And Sister Lucy Hughes was the first person to, I think,
alderman that of Alderman Sarah. We are here at Metropolitan, the WMS named after its first local president, Ms. Carrie B. Warren. Here we are, we're called the Missionary Society, called the Carrie B. Warren Missionary Society. And under that particular name and title, we do a lot of things in regards to supporting the neighborhood. We do a lot of things in regards to holidays. We have what we call the Bridesmaid Lunch. We support them. We have the crab breakfasts once a year. We have our young people, our YPP. And that's another thing. YPP falls underneath the Missionary Society. We have the YPP. In the year to pass, at Easter time, we would take the YPBs to the Easter Pageant at the Home Auditorium. And it would be like 7 o'clock in the morning. Believe it or not, those young people ready, willing, and able to go to those particular activities and enjoy them immensely. And we just want to thank the Metropolitan and certainly our pastor's wife for being so supportive of us. And the things that we do, the Missionary Society also have what we call, we organize a gospel and song, where we invite other missionaries and other people, other women, other men. Men, you're welcome to come. And they come and we, have our gospel and song. And that's one of our fundraisers. We have a fifth Sunday that we participate. We bring the messages and we do the services on our fifth Sunday. So we do a lot of things. At Christmas time, we fix baskets, beautiful baskets. You all should see the ones we did the last time. They were absolutely incredible. We thought about maybe just put them in Walmart. And really make some change out of them. But anyway, we did just lots and lots of them together. And it's so much fun to just come here and work with all the rest of the women here. We just have a good time. We're going to miss some of our wonderful people like Gwen, who always the spearhead of all of that activity. She's just been so wonderful in working with us and helping to pull us all together. And she called us and she said, listen, you need to make sure that you bring what you're supposed to bring and you need to be on time. And so we want to give a shout out to her and say a super prayer for her, because she has really been one of our faithful members, and she's not with us today because she's still ill and not able to come. Christmas, we have a Thanksgiving dinner that we were serving for the homeless people, and we have served over 200 to 400 people at any given time. And we just want to be able to thank you for all of your support. Our members bring in all of our, they donate turkeys and all those kinds of things so that we can feed our homeless people. Those are just a few things. The missionary complied with the committees. As a commissioner, we are committed to finding ways to bless those who need our community support. WMS women members participate in all sorts of services, like I said before. The meals, we have the flats and serve on sick and shut-in people every Saturday. Saturday morning, those people who are unable to come to church and have their meal. And as recently, yours too was named one of the new initiatives for the Missionary Society of the Pearls. We usually have the life members, but now we have what we call the Pearls. And I was inducted as one of the Pearls this last time. And as we established the auxiliary of our church, part of our budget goes to the district, the connection of WMS efforts. These include projects in Haiti, such as pillowcases, dresses for Haitians, offering girls, and more recently, money for the Ebola relief was sent to West Africa. Again, we want to say thank you for all your support. Thank you for everything that you've done here today. Thank you for showing up today. And we want to give a big shout out for the kids, because they were absolutely incredible. Again, thank you.
First, Ms. Chastity, Antoinette Webb. come on up and give us your camera. Shower curtain? Yes, Mama. All right, then. Thank you very much. Special guest soloist, Mr. Walter J.
All right.
White, Brother E. Charles Johnson, Brother Irvin Elijah Ray Stover, 3 years old. Our next one, John Paul J.P. Pratt.
Woo!
1, fall to the 2nd.
Esteemed president, who has been joined to work with, you say thank you. for blessing us. And once again, if you would do me a favor and take this brother really hard, our resident musician.
Doing your way.
children can be blessed. So today was, amen, our children's day. And we thank God for your talents, for your gifts, for who they are. Need I remind you, beloved, that what you saw today are not just our children. You saw future nurses and future doctors. Future. Amen. So let's give God a big hand.
Jesus loves me, this I know.